I'm Dr. Sandeep Jha. I'm a liver disease specialist and a liver transplant surgeon. And I work as a consultant at Manipal Hospital, which is in Dwarka, Delhi, India. Over my years of experience, I've interacted with thousands of patients of chronic liver disease and cirrhosis. And I've been involved in numerous living donor liver transplant cases over these years. Today, we are going to talk about what is cirrhosis? Quick overview of cirrhosis. So, cirrhosis is a slow progressing chronic disease. It is unlike a brain stroke or a heart attack where things quickly deteriorate within a matter of hours to days. In chronic liver disease, you don't need to panic. You have time on your side and you can effectively plan and fight against chronic liver disease and cirrhosis. What's amazing is there's effective treatment available for all leading causes of cirrhosis. The most common causes of cirrhosis are chronic hepatitis B virus infection, chronic hepatitis C virus infection, uncontrolled diabetes, alcoholic liver disease, and obesity. So these are the most common causes of cirrhosis, which contribute to more than 80 to 90% of cases of cirrhosis. And as you can see, as of today, very effective treatment is available for all these conditions. For hepatitis B virus, you have very effective medications that can effectively neutralize all the virus in the body. For hepatitis C, we have directly acting antiviral agents that are very effective and can eliminate hepatitis C virus from the body. You can quit alcohol with or without help. You can quit alcohol and reverse any chronic liver disease or cirrhosis changes. You can fight diabetes by effectively controlling your sugar. And obesity is, as of today, is controllable by both medications and surgery. So if we are well informed and chronic liver disease is diagnosed in a timely manner, then we can effectively fight cirrhosis. So what are the stages when you go to a doctor? Usually the diagnosis of cirrhosis is made on a basis of clinical history. The doctor will talk to you, he'll ask about your symptoms, he'll order some blood tests, and also he'll order some imaging scans, which include ultrasound. It can include a CT scan or a fibro scan, and also he may order upper GI endoscopy. So all these investigations are required to come to confirm a diagnosis of cirrhosis or chronic liver disease. And until obviously, if you are very advanced in your disease where your symptoms are very obvious, then you might not require these tests. But to catch a chronic liver disease or cirrhosis early, most of these tests are required to be done and then arrive at a diagnosis of cirrhosis or chronic liver disease. Usually a chronic liver disease progresses from a normal liver to a fatty liver to a fibrotic liver to a cirrhotic stage, and then eventually to a decompensated cirrhosis stage, which is the end stage liver disease. And we'll talk about these stages in the subsequent videos and what we can do to effectively fight this disease at each of these stages. One thing I want to stress, that as of today, a biopsy is not required to make a diagnosis of cirrhosis in most of the cases. In rare cases only, we require a biopsy to confirm a diagnosis of cirrhosis. So in subsequent videos, we'll talk about every small aspect of chronic liver disease and cirrhosis, so you can have good information and you can understand your disease, which will help you fight cirrhosis effectively. So if you think this video is helpful for you and you are suffering from chronic liver disease or cirrhosis, or you know someone who's suffering from chronic liver disease and cirrhosis, then please ask them to connect to this channel and subscribe to it so that they can benefit from this information and fight their disease better. Thank you.